visitors will learn about her when they come to Grand Rapids, Michael?
Well, there's a great story there with my mother, as you know, a very strong-willed and outspoken person, very, very much a leader of women's rights, and her campaign for the ERA. They'll see that in the exhibits. They'll also see her story of facing not only breast cancer and just the, you know, the illness and the, you know, the challenge there, but also facing her own alcohol and drug dependency, and being able to kind of persevere and overcome with the help of loved ones and with her faith in God.
It's remarkable stuff, Michael, and I want to thank you for sharing that with us today, and congratulations. Long overdue, and the folks in Grand Rapids have an American treasure, so congratulations and enjoy the week, Michael. Thanks.
Thank you very much, Bill.
You bet. ISIS fighters gunning down civilians who try to escape a war zone. They are worried about moles on the inside. Families desperately trying to get across the river to get out of Fallujah. Iraqi forces and American warplanes, they've been fighting back to try and win that city over, with thousands of civilians trapped inside. We will get a live update on that battle coming up inside the Fox News deck. Next. Two years ago today, more than 150,000 Allied forces stormed the beaches of Normandy. In what would later become known as D-Day, the biggest seaborne assault in military history, By the end of that day, thousands of troops were dead. Today, veterans and relatives of those who died were in France to pay their respects. And Hank Tussey from California landed on Normandy. You can see him saluting during the playing of taps today. Henry Breton of Maine was also part of the invasion and says this date always brings back so many memories. Peggy Harris's husband, Billy, died in the assault. She could not be there, so friends placed a picture of her at Billy's grave. The fight for the ISIS stronghold of Fallujah has forced people who live there to make an incredibly tough decision, either try and escape or stay holed up inside. Iraqi officials say terrorists have been gunning down some of those who try to run away. Meanwhile, families have been trying to make the dangerous trip across the Euphrates River, often grabbing a hold of anything that will float to make it to the other side. Officials say at least four have drowned, including two children. Nine others are missing in that river. Iraqi forces saying they're now advancing into the center of the town. Airstrikes from the Islamic coalition overhead have supported that assault. Yet Iraqi officials and aid workers say tens of thousands of civilians still trapped inside Fallujah cannot get out. Connor Powell's live at the Middle East Bureau watching this story. And Connor, do we know how close the Iraqi forces are to taking the city back?
Yeah, Bill, this operation was launched 2 weeks ago, and while it is moving slowly, it is in fact moving forward, and the Iraqi troops are advancing on Fallujah. The entire city is essentially cut off from the outside world, so ISIS fighters there have really no way of getting resupplied or have any extra reinforcements be sent into the city. And Iraqi troops have secured the southern part of the city. They are beginning to move in, although there are some 50,000 or so civilians there, many of them desperate to leave, some, as you pointed out, trying to flee by jumping into boats or rafts across the Euphrates, snipers from ISIS picking some of them off, according to humanitarian groups, others drowning in the river in desperation to flee that place. So this operation is moving. It is moving slowly, but it is moving forward. And Iraqi troops, while they've boasted about doing this quickly, they are doing it fairly methodically in an effort to protect the civilian population there. There is every reason to believe that it will take a long time, but Bill, that it will ultimately be successful. That's what we've seen in Tikrit. It's also what we saw in Ramadi.
How does this impact the operation on Mosul, which is, as you know, the other stronghold and perhaps the most significant that ISIS controls in that country in terms of size, et cetera, economy?
Yeah, that's right. The Pentagon was pushing this winter for Mosul to be the focus of the military operations this summer, or maybe even early as this past spring. But because ISIS has launched a series of bombings in Baghdad in the last few weeks, really trying to raise sectarian tensions between Sunni and Shia, the Iraqi government focused their attention on Fallujah, which is only about 40 or so miles outside of Baghdad. That's taken the effort away from Mosul. There's no real timeline, Bill, on when the U.S. coalition and the Iraqi troops will move on Mosul. It could be as late as next summer.
The battle that will be. Connor Powell, thanks, on our Middle East Bureau there. Right back in a moment with a look at the birth of a longtime American tradition that has now almost vanished entirely. And it happened on this day in history. Thank you.